he didn't want people to see him deteriorating. He didn't want to put them through the upset.
We went downstairs and we played a game of Scrabble. And I drank champagne. And just the two of us. And as I left, he said, "Thank you for spending the afternoon with an old man."
I saw a man become incredibly brave. I saw a man become incredibly emotional at times. I saw depths of this person that was an exaggeration of what was, that had been primarily there all these years, all those years. And respected and admired him even more.
He would sleep, wake up, sleep, wake up. I mean, the television would be on, you know, and sometimes he'd talk for a few minutes. But it was just sitting there, holding hands, so that he knew someone was sitting there with him. Sunday morning, early, that he just sort of, his breathing changed. We called the doctor and he explained. He says, "Well, no, basically what's happened, he has gone into a coma now." Mary came and went. His parents called up, but the doctor said, "No, not, don't let them come now. He might be, you know, he might be better later on," that sort of thing. And we just stopped people from coming because he was, you know, the state he was in. As the doctor was over in the mews just getting into his car, Jim and I were up there. We were going to change his clothes and noticed that his chest wasn't moving, that he'd stopped breathing.
I went up and
I just said to Phoebe, "Peter, he's gone." I suppose the usual thing, you know, CV is breathing, the mirror, and I just looked at them both and said, "He's gone. Phone Mary."
He'd given himself a limit, and I think personally that when he couldn't record anymore or have the energy to do that anymore, then it would be the end, because his life really had been his work, and I think his joy had been that, and I think without it he wouldn't have been strong enough to face what he had to face. So he did it on his own terms.
It was very, very upsetting because obviously I knew it was coming, but I just didn't want it to come. So, yeah, I can picture it when it happened, the day, the time. But It was still a shock because I didn't think it would be coming when it did. I was hoping there'll be a cure, we just got to hang on and it'll come, but even now there's no cure, isn't there?
The medications obviously are, you know, they're getting there. Speed didn't happen a few years ago, but there's life.
I suppose his time was up and that was it.
He suddenly announced one day after Sunday lunch, "I know exactly where I want you to put me." And "but no one's to know because I don't want anyone to dig me up," were his exact words. "And I just want to rest in peace."
You're the last person I'm talking to, Phil. You probably get the best interview, darling, don't you?
I don't want to change the world. To me, happiness is the most important thing. If I'm happy, then it shows in my work.
In the end, all the mistakes and all the excuses are down to me. I'd like to feel that I'm just being my honest self. And as far as I'm concerned, I just want to pack in as much of life and fun, having a good time, as much as I can within the years I have.
Well, there you are. You have it on tape. Use it.
Well, it's the nearest I've come to a lot of passion in terms of interviews. How much more have you got now? Come on, I'm getting bored.
C'est la vie.
In my defense, what is there to say? All the mistakes we made must be faced today. It's not easy now, knowing where to start.
Slightly differently.